Dear friends, welcome to another video tutorial. Today we're going to see how to use the TCS230 color sensor with Arduino. It is a very interesting sensor that will enable us to build some amazing projects. Without any further delay, let's get started. Hey guys, I am Nick and welcome to Educates TV, a channel that is all about do-it-yourself electronics projects with Arduino, Raspberry Pi, ESP8266 and other popular boards. In this video, we are going to learn how to use the TSC230 color sensor, a very interesting sensor. I have built a simple project to demonstrate that this sensor is really capable. I use an Arduino Uno and a 1.8-inch color TFT display and of course the color sensor. As you can see, the sensor detects the colors and it displays them on the screen. The color we get on the screen is pretty close to the real color of the object. Cool, isn't it? Now, let's see the parts that we need in order to build this project. The parts needed are these: an Arduino Uno, a TSC230 color sensor, a 1.8-inch color TFT display, a small breadboard and some wires. The color sensor costs around $5, so the total cost of the project is around $15. You can find links for all the parts in the description of the video below. The color sensor module consists of the color sensor itself and 4 LEDs to illuminate the object in front of the sensor in order to get more accurate readings. The color sensor consists of an array of photodiodes with color filters on top. There are 4 types of filters: red, blue, green and a clear filter. There are multiple photodiodes of each color and this helps improve the accuracy of the readings. The output is a 50% duty cycle square wave with a frequency proportional to the light intensity on the selected filter. Let's now see how to connect the sensor to Arduino. In order to make this sensor work with Arduino, we only have to connect 6 wires. Some of the pins of this module will stay unconnected. We connect the positive rail of the breadboard to Arduino 5V and the ground rail of the breadboard to Arduino ground. Next, we connect the VCC pin of the sensor to breadboard's positive rail and the ground pin of the sensor to the negative rail of the breadboard. The S2 pin goes to diesel pin 2 of the Arduino. The S3 pin goes to diesel pin 3. The OE pin, output enable, goes to diesel pin 4. Lastly, the out pin of the sensor goes to diesel pin 5. If your sensor module also has an LED pin connected to 5V in order to light up the LEDs. That's it. Now we have to connect the display and we are ready. Please watch the detailed tutorial I have prepared on how to connect this display to Arduino. If we now power up the project, it will display a splash screen for 3 seconds. Next, the calibration procedure will start. In order to get more accurate colors, we have to calibrate the sensor. We first place the sensor on a black object and then on a white object. Now the sensor knows which color is black and which is white, so it can accurately report all the other colors. As you can see, the project works fine. Let's now see the software side of the project. In order to use the color sensor, we need 2 libraries. We need the TCS230 library and the frequency library. We also need 2 libraries for the display. You can find links for all the libraries we use in the description of the video. First of all, we initialize the display and we display the splash screen. Next, we initialize the sensor and we read the color from it. We set the first color we read as black because first we have to calibrate the sensor. Next, we read the sensor again and we set the color we read as white. After the calibration is over, we read the sensor and we display the color we get on the display. Before printing the color on the display, we first have to convert it to a 16-bit value. The color sensor outputs a 24-bit color value, but our display can only display 16-bit colors. That's why we need to convert the colors before printing them with this function. With this line of code, we display a small rectangle with the color we read from the sensor. As always, you can find the code of the project in the description of the video below. As you can see, the color sensor is a great addition to our Arduino sensors. With this sensor available, we can build many interesting projects. We can add a color sensor to a robot or a robotic arm, or we can build a color sorting machine. I'm really interested in a color sorting machine that will have a practical implementation. I live in Greece and many Greek farmers grow olive trees for a living. They sell either the olive oil they produce or the olives for consumption. Black black olives are sold in higher prices than green olives. What if we could sort the olives by color with the help of a simple and low-cost Arduino machine? That would mean better income for farmers and less time sorting the olives by hand. I will try to build a project like this in the future and I will post a video about it. I would love to hear your thoughts on the color sensor. What other projects do you plan to build with a sensor like this? Please post your comments or ideas below. Thank you! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.